How to change brake pads on a 94 Polaris Sportsman 400. I got these off of eBay. Mine were shot. This is my whole wheel cylinder and everything caliper. So what you want to do is, in order to get these old pads off, you see there's these studs there. You need to take that nut out, an Allen wrench. See that? Spin it out. It comes out like that. And I'm going to go ahead and remove this because we need to push the wheel cylinder in, or the brake cylinder in, once I put the new pads on. So the way this works is you got a rubber seal here, and this metal part moves in and out, so you should be able to push that in. And as you're pushing that in, you can see it actually pushes into that hole all the way through. Push as hard as you can, and you should be able to get your brake pads off. There's one, slide it up and over. And I'll show you this one more time. This is kind of stiff, but this moves in and out. And push it all the way back as far as you can. Now, what I like to do is, let's pull this all the way out. You got a rubber boot on there, so take your rubber boot off each side. Pull this completely out. Oops. All right, so you see how dry that is there? You want that to slide in and out real nice. You grab a little grease, throw it on there. The way it'll slide back and forth really nice when you hit the brakes. Go ahead and reassemble it. It's back in there like so. Push it in. I like to squeeze it on until sometimes the boot will seal itself. You just squeezed in. You want to double check it. Make sure your boots are completely sealed. Make sure it goes in and out nice like you want it to. It still isn't moving that well. There we go. Right. Got some grease in there. Now, get your new pads. Now what you can do, I mean, you can use a C-clamp, whatever, to push that in. I'm just going to take a rubber mallet and just give it a shove. There we go. Got that pushed down. Ew, got some crap in there. Clean that out. Now it's gonna be a lot easier to reassemble your new brakes. As you can see, these weren't horrible, but they got some wear to them, so I'm gonna replace them. You just assemble them back the same way you did before. Make sure this is squeezed in all the way. Go ahead and put this on. Slide it up and in. There's one. Go ahead and do the same thing with the other side. Not so bad. Slide that out a little bit. Put this little lock nut in there. Probably put a little sealer on the threads if you want. And try to put it back about where it was. If you go in too deep, then it might set your brake pads in or out. That's something you can adjust later on. That's it. There's nothing to it. And don't forget to put this back in. See, it's dirty. I'm going to clean it up. Now I'm ready to mount it to the ATV. Thanks for watching. Hope you learned something. Stay tuned for my other videos and please subscribe.